After the rise of Taoism at the end of the Eastern Han Dynasty in the early 3rd century AD, the Wudang Mountains came to be called Mountains of the Immortals, or Mountains of the Tao. Taoism has left its traces everywhere on these mountains, from their highest ridges to their deepest valleys. Countless legends and mysteries swirl among their mists. In the world of Kung Fu too, word spread far and wide that in the Wudang Mountains, martial experts of incomparable skill had assiduously developed remarkable internal fighting styles. One day in the turbulent years of the mid-14th century, when the Yuan dynasty collapsed and was replaced by the Ming, a disheveled-looking Taoist suddenly arrived in the Wudang Mountains. People called him Ragtag John, but few guessed that his scruffy exterior concealed consummate martial arts skills. Hidden away in the Wudang Mountains, Zhang founded a style of Kung Fu which later became one of the major branches of the Chinese martial arts. Ragtag Zhang's real name was Zhang Sanfeng, but we have little concrete knowledge of his history. Some say he lived in the reign of the Northern Song Emperor Huizong in the early 12th century. Others claim that he was born near the beginning of the Yuan Dynasty, in the second year of Emperor Dingzong's reign, 1247. But in the Wudang Mountains, they say that in fact there were two Zhang Sanfengs who lived 100 or so years apart. But which of them was the founder of Wudang Kung Fu? Opinions differ. Maybe it was, but it was surely Zhang Sanfeng, no doubt about it.
那乌兰山呢，一般我们念经功呢，就要先正其心，就是说，直接把思想先正确起来，所以思想呢，就是没得一切的歪了歪歪改的烦恼，是吧？就是安静一切的思想，再一个呢，就开始念自己的经功，使自己的神意、心一切都神心意都归于自己的内心境界，是吧？慢慢的就入境。 才成为这是成为养生，是吧？另外的在行动方面呢，就要呢，只要一动着就要立恩。但是我们卢老师不练功的，做一切事情都要利于大家的利益，是吧？就是动着立恩呢，静着立己，安静下来呢，就修养自己的精神，使自己的精神呢有初步的，就是三乘功法，是吧？把心一静以后。 得到一样法身的时候，就那个就要念经化气的，一样法动的时候，念经化气，这个过程呢非常比较长，是吧？因为人的思想啊，在这样人呐过生活一段过程，就是很长，把自己的被外界的环境呐、都还反成的事情。